Learn stuff from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1833. Bob Umlas, 15th and last of the month. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. Again, I have another guest post from Bob Umlas. Bob?
Hi, this is Bob Umlas talking to you from the MVP Summit in good old Washington. What we're looking at is the result that we want to achieve. That is, we want the 15th of the month followed by the end date of the month, then the 15th of the next month, and so on. So this is the goal, and let's take a look at some of the attempts that we do. You might first start to use the fill handle. So the attempt one, I put in the 15th of the month and the 31st of the month, and I select them both, and I drag the fill handle down. I know it's going to go to row 24, but this is quite a mess. The first one is off, 216, 34. And the reason it's doing that is because they're not consistent. The end of every month is not exactly 15 or 16 days. So this is just a horrible mess. So attempt one, we get rid of that. Attempt two, we might start with the 15th of each 2 months. And then we select this range. And if I drag that down to row 24, it's a pretty good start to give us the 15th of each month. Now I can go to blanks, go to special, the F5 key, go to special, and I click on the blanks, and I have all the blanks selected aside, including the last one because I went to the 24th. Okay, so in A2, I'm going to enter the month that I'm, the month following that cell, minus 15. So 15 days before that, and if I control enter, it'll fill every cell with the same formula as if I did a fill down. Let me just widen this even more. This one, there is no cell, there's nothing in A25, so A25 minus 15 doesn't exist, and that's why it says manually enter 1231. So that was a lot better because it worked. But the best way is to start the way we originally did, the 15th and the 31st. But instead of using the regular fill handle, I right-mouse-click the fill handle. And when I let go, it gives me some options. And one of the options is just fill months. And we're done. It's smart enough to do that. Thank you.
All right, there you go. Now, Bob has been a Microsoft Excel MVP longer than any MVP. He was there when the program started. Great way to simplify that task. And we'll have more podcasts from Bob over the coming weeks. So check it out. Again, the link right down there in the YouTube comments. Thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.